Alright, so in the previous two videos, we set up our dataset and trained a multilayer perceptron in PyTorch. In this video, we are now going to add the Lightning module to it and train the PyTorch multilayer perceptron using the Lightning trainer. Similar to before, we will start by adding our imports here. So here are the imports that we are going to use for this notebook. And then since we are now talking about a Lightning module, let us define our Lightning module and call it Lightning model. So this Lightning model will wrap our PyTorch model, and then we can use the Lightning trainer for easier training. So how does this Lightning model look like? We have this init constructor here, which receives a model. This will be a PyTorch model, and then we have the learning rate as a hyperparameter. So here we are just saving this hyperparameter and the model as attributes. Then we have this forward method, which is calling the PyTorch model on the inputs x, which are our features, the dataset features, or here in this case, the mnist images. Then we have this training step here, which receives a mini batch here. And what we are going to do is we save the features and the true labels as separate variables, just so that it's easier to read. And of course, we are feeding the features to the model. So here we are just calling self, and self, by convention, it's how it's implemented, will call forward, and forward will call the model. So here, essentially, we are just executing the model on the features to receive the outputs from the last layer, the logits. Then we are feeding the logits to the cross entropy loss, and then we are logging the loss and call it training loss. So this is the loss that is computed for the mini batch here that we are feeding as input. So now when we look at this, this code is essentially the same code that we used when we were training our PyTorch models before. It's essentially just how we perform one training step. Notice we are only computing the loss, and the Lightning module itself will take care of the optimizer. So the loss is then passed to the optimizer, and we don't have to worry about doing the optimizer zeroing of the gradients and applying the step. So this is automatically taken care of by the Lightning module. Now let's take a look at the validation step. The validation step is essentially how we compute a forward pass in the network so that we can use this code to compute the validation set loss, for example. The code here is exactly the same as above, so the first three lines are identical. The only difference is that we are logging it as the validation loss and not the training loss. And of course, the validation set loss is not used for training the model, it's only used for validation. And then we have this configure optimizers method here, which initializes a stochastic gradient descent optimizer and returns it. And again, this is automatically used by the Lightning module. All we have to define is how we compute the forward path, the training step, then the validation step, and of course the optimizers. And as you can see, this helps us to keep our code a little bit more organized, because that's much neater than, let's say, our manual training function that we implemented in PyTorch earlier. So next, let's add the lines that will be executed when we run this code as a script. So again, here we have the same code that we used in the previous script file. There's no difference here. The new part comes now. So what we are going to do now is we are initializing a new Lightning module, and this Lightning module will receive the PyTorch model that we define here, our PyTorch multilayer perceptron, and we are defining a learning rate here. So this is initializing our Lightning module. The next step is then initializing the Lightning trainer. So here we are using the Lightning trainer, and we specify 10 epochs. As the accelerator, we are setting it to auto, and the devices are also set to auto. If you have a laptop with a single GPU, this would be essentially similar to GPU and one. Or if you have, let's say, a computer with multiple GPUs, let's say four GPUs, it will be using four GPUs. Or if you have a laptop with only a CPU, it will be running this on the CPU. So in this case, if you say auto, it will use whatever resources are available. However, like here, we can also manually specify this. So for that, we are going to need the Lightning model that we defined up here. Then we need the training loaders and the validation set loader. So now we defined both the Lightning module and the trainer. And the next step, of course, is now fitting the model. So we are going to use the fit method of the trainer to fit the model. So as input to the trainer fit method, we are feeding the lightning model, the training set data loader, and the validation set data loader. And then as the last thing, what we are going to do is, of course, computing the accuracy. So later on, we will find out about more convenient ways that are built into Lightning. But just for now, so that we are not introducing too many things at once, we will take a look at our compute accuracy function, which we defined earlier in earlier videos. All right, so if this looks good to you, we can hit the play button and train our model and see what we get. So we can see during training, we see this handy epoch progress bar. And then also after the first epoch, we see the validation set loss, which we want to see going down during training. It will take a while, 10 epochs until this finishes, but let's maybe skip ahead and see what the results look like. All right, so now that the training has finished, we can take a look at the training accuracies and the validation and test accuracy. We can see we achieve 97% training accuracy, 96% validation and test accuracy, which looks pretty good to me. In this video, we learned how to organize our PyTorch code using a Lightning module, and we trained this multilayer perceptron using the Lightning trainer. And in the upcoming videos, we will talk about one more thing, Torch metrics, which helps us further with our code organization here.